Hi all, today we are going to discuss about capacitance of three-phase transmission line. So first let us start with unsymmetrically spaced three-phase transmission line so that we can easily calculate the symmetrically transposed line easily from these derivations. So let us take three conductors. The conductors I am taking as A, B and C of a transmission line. Let us assume the distance between these conductors. So this I am naming as DAB between A and B, and this distance is DBC. And this distance is DCA or DAC, whatever you take it. And let us assume the radius of each conductor is given by R, and the distance of separation between the conductors is far, far greater than the radius. So this is the second approximation we are taking. And it is also assumed that this transmission line is perfectly transposed transmission line. What is the meaning of transposition? Each conductor will occupy each and every position at least once. So initially at position number 1, A will be here, B will be here and C will be here. So in the second position after one third distance, the A will move to B, B will be moved to C position and C will move to A position. Then in the similar way, the third position will be there. So then we can call this transmission line as a transposer line. That means we can divide our transmission line into three different sections. So let us find the expression for each of these sections, the potential between point A and B. So then we will calculate the average value of the inductance from that. So let us try to calculate this one. So first will be equal to VAB in position number 1. So in position number 1, because last class we have seen how to calculate this one. So this will be equal to, due to charge A, this is QA divided by 2 pi epsilon naught into ln of. So we are moving from B to A because we want the potential of A with respect to B. So distance of B with respect to A is DAB divided by distance of conductor A with respect to A will be from the surface of the conductor, because we have to take from surface of the conductor. I am taking the radius is equal to R, small r or capital R, whatever you take. So please don't confuse in this. So then due to the charge B, this will be QB divided by 2 pi epsilon naught ln of. So we have to move from with respect to the conductor B. What is the distance of conductor B? Distance of conductor B with respect to it will be R, because inside the conductor there will be no electric field. We have to start from surface only. Divided by distance of conductor B with respect to A, because we are moving from conductor B to conductor A. So there the distance is DAB. So actually it will be equal to DAB minus the radius of the second conductor, because DAB minus R, this I can approximate as DAB. That is the reason I am directly writing the distance here. So this thing we have already discussed in our previous classes. That's why I am not going into details. So then because of the third charge will be QC divided by 2 pi epsilon naught into ln of. Now we are moving from B to A. So distance of C with respect to B will be CBC DBC divided by distance of C with respect to A. This will become equal to DCA, because we are moving from BC to AC. So this is in position number 1. Similarly, in position number 2, what happens? The conductor A, B, C, they will interchange now. So again, this distances I am taking as same only. So this is DAB, DBC, DCA, but conductor A is shifted here, B will be shifted here and C will be shifted here. So let us calculate what is the value of potential between the conductor A and B in position number 2. So that is why taking as 2. So this will be QA divided by 2 pi epsilon naught into ln of. So we want to calculate between A and B. So between A and B, that means distance of B will be DBC here in this case, divided by up to conductor A. Conductor A we have to take up to surface, so it will be R, plus due to charge B, this will be QB divided by 2 pi epsilon naught ln of. We have to move from conductor B. So distance of B with respect to B will be R, divided by distance of B with respect to A in this diagram will be DBC, plus, so similar is the case for the third charge. So this will be equal to QC divided by 2 pi epsilon naught into ln of. So distance of C with respect to B, this will be DCA divided by distance of C with respect to A in this particular position will be DAB. So please refer to this diagram. So this is the case for second condition. So similar is the case for the third position I can derive. So third position, again the conductors will be shifted. So these are the positions. So this is DAB, this is DBC, this is equal to DCA. So now the conductors are further shifted. The conductor A reached here, B reached here and C reached here. So in this condition we have to write. So this will be equal to VAB in the third position. So VAB in the third position will be QA divided by 2 pi epsilon naught ln of. So the distance will be with respect to B, it is DBC divided by R, plus similarly QB divided by 2 pi epsilon naught into ln of R divided by QB. So distance of B with respect to conductor A. So this will become equal to DC A. So this is also equal to DCA, right? DAC or DCA. Sorry, please change it. Because B is here, A is here, I have confused. So now coming to the conductor C, so this will be QC divided by 2 pi epsilon naught into ln of distance of conductor C, C to B. C to B will be equal to DAB. We are moving again from D to C to A. So this will be DBC. This is the value. So these are the three equations. So now the average potential difference. So average potential difference between conductors A and B will be equal to VAB is equal to VAB in position 1 plus VAB in position number 2 plus VAB in position number 3 divided by 3. So this I can write as 1 by 3 times of, take the sum of all these three equations. So when you take the sum, this will become ln of DAB DBC DCA divided by R cube plus QB into ln of R cube divided by DAB DBC DCA plus QC into ln of DAB DBC DCA divided by DAB into DBC into DCA. So you can see here this numerator and denominator is same, so it will become ln of 1. So ln of 1 will be equal to 0. So that's why the third term will cancel, only two terms will be remaining here. So this I can write as 1 by 2 pi epsilon naught into QA into ln of D equivalent value by R plus QB into ln of R by D equivalent. I can write in this form. So this is the value of VAB. So where the value of this D equivalent value is DAB multiplied by DBC multiplied by DCA whole to the power of 1 by 2. This is the equivalent distance between the conductors, or this is nothing but equal to geometrical mean distance. This is what we have seen before also. So similar way, you can calculate the value of VAC. I am directly writing the equation because similar procedure you can follow, you will get the same answer, QA into ln of D equivalent divided by R plus QC into ln of R by D equivalent. So this is what we get if you calculate between A and C. So now we know in the phasor form, so this is my value of VAN, let us assume I am taking as reference, this is my value of VBN and this is my value of VCN. So from this I can calculate my line voltage or VAB. VAB will be equal to VAN minus VBN. So if you take the vector sum of these two, this will become my value of VAB. So similarly, I can calculate my VAC. VAC will be equal to VAN minus VCN. So how this comes, you can please refer to my basic electrical engineering. There I have explained that star connection of three phase transmission lines. So three phase systems, star connection, there I have explained this in detail, how the line voltages and the phase voltage relationships comes. So from this I can calculate this one value, this will be equal to VAC. So now I want to take the sum of VAB plus VAC. So if you want to take the sum of VAB plus VAC, you can see here this will be 30 degrees. This will be 30 degrees, that means total angle will be 60 degrees. So sum, resultant sum will be in the center of this, so resultant will come here. This will be value of VAB plus VAC. So if you calculate the line values, we know the line values will be root 3 times of the phase values. So this will also be VAB also will be equal to root 3 times of V phase value, but having some angle. So this VAB plus VAC, you can calculate from P square plus Q square plus 2PQ, cos of the angle between them. Cos of the angle between them is 60 degrees. So this VAB plus VBC will be equal to square root of VAB square plus VAC square plus 2 times of VAB into VAC into cos 60 degrees. So this I can write as square root of 3 times of V phase plus 3 times of V phase, because this will be square, plus 2 into 3 times of V phase square into cos 60 degrees. Cos 60 degrees will be 1 by 2. So this will become square root of 9 times of V phase square, or this will become 3 times of V phase, or this is nothing but 3 times of VAN, because it is in the direction of VAN. We can write it as VAN direction, it is coming as 3 times. So we can conclude that if you are taking the sum of VAB plus VAC, we will get as 3 times of VAN. So because I want the capacitance with respect to neutral, AN neutral, that is why I have calculated this one. So this will be sum of the two equations which we derived. So this will become 1 by 2 pi epsilon naught into QA into ln of D equivalent divided by R plus QB into ln of R by D equivalent. And the second equation is 1 by 2 pi epsilon naught into QA into ln of D equivalent divided by R plus QC into ln of R divided by D equivalent value. This is what we get. So now taking the sum of these two, this becomes 1 by 2 pi epsilon naught. This becomes 2 times of QA into ln of D equivalent divided by R plus QB plus QC ln of R by D equivalent value. So we know that QA plus QB plus QC is equal to 0. So this becomes equal to minus QA. Why? The reason is we know that total sum of the currents will be equal to 0, or total sum of the charges is equal to 0 in a three-phase balanced system. So from this I have calculated this as minus QA. So this I can write as 3 times of VAN will be equal to, if you are making this as minus QA, so that minus sign if you take here, this numerator denominator will reverse. So that's why this I can write as 3 times of QA, or this I can write as 3 times of 1 by 2 pi epsilon naught into QA into ln of D equivalent value divided by R. This is what we get. So from this I can calculate my VAN is equal to QA by 2 pi epsilon naught ln of D equivalent divided by R. This is what we get. So from this I can calculate my capacitance between conductor A and neutral will be the charge on that particular capacitor divided by the voltage of the particular capacitor, right, VAN. So if you calculate this VAN, so substituting, this will become 2 pi epsilon naught divided by ln of D equivalent divided by R. So the units are in farads per meter, because Q is the charge per unit length or per charge per meter length. So this will be farads per meter. So similar way I can calculate my value of CBN, and CCN can be calculated in the similar way. And if you calculate it, because the system is transposed, so all these will be equal to same, equal to CAN. So here you can see here in the denominator, this is equal to D equivalent. D equivalent is nothing but GMD, and the denominator will be geometric mean radius should come, that means R dash should come, or the self GMD should come. But here in the case of capacitance, because capacitance will start from the surface, there are no internal flux linkages or such concept. So here you have to take R only, not R dash. That is the difference between inductance and capacitance calculations. So let us now see what is the capacitance of symmetrically spaced three phase lines. Symmetrically spaced lines. So in the case of symmetrically spaced lines, so the distance between the conductors will be same. So this is also equal to D, this is also equal to D, this is also equal to D. So when they are symmetrically spaced, this DAB will be equal to DBC equal to DCA is equal to D. So I can tell that D equivalent value is equal to square root of D multiplied by this D. So this is the value we get. So this D equivalent value will be automatically equal to the distance of separation between them. So this will become equal to D only. So that is the only thing, because this is not square root, this is cubed root, right? So cubed root, because three elements are there, cubed root of D multiplied by D multiplied by D. So automatically this will be equal to D only. So in the above equation, if you substitute this, you will get it as CAN is equal to QA divided by VAN. So that will be equal to 2 pi epsilon naught divided by ln of D divided by R. So forget about the symmetrically spaced line, only you remember that in order to calculate the capacitance of any three phase transmission line, this is the equation, you have to calculate 2 pi epsilon naught divided by ln of GMD divided by GMR. But GMR in the case of capacitance calculation will be different. You should not take R dash, you have to take R. Remaining all will be, it will be same only. Please remember this. If you substitute this, you will get it automatically. So how to calculate the GMD and GMR, those things we have already discussed before. I hope how to calculate the three phase Capacitance of three-phase transmission line is completely clear to you. If you still have any queries, you can leave your comments in the comment section below. I will answer to your queries from there. Thank you. Thank you very much.